Hello everyone, my name is Hezekiah Richardson and I am a member and I attend the Colby Methodist Church. I am a young adult at the age of 20. I play my saxophone in the church and I'm a part of the music ministry. I am also a vocalist in the 7-year-old group called the Fearless Ones.
So fearfully and wonderfully made, how could they say there is no God? Reminded every breath that I take, it's by your hand I have been formed. So what am I gonna do with this life you gave me? What could I do but live for your praise? You gave me this breath, and you gave me this strength, and every day I live to obey.
Now give an opening prayer. Father God, we gather here today under your care and protection. Thank you for your loving kindness that never fails us in our darkest of times. We thank you for bringing us together through social media. May someone be blessed and may someone be saved by this form of ministry. In Jesus' name, amen. The scripture reading from today is taken from Psalms chapter 139. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. The name of my meditation is Judgment Belongs to God Alone. My meditation will be taken from the scripture Psalms chapter 139, verse 15. My frame was not hidden from you when I was being made in secret, intricately woven in the depths of the earth. Within this psalm, we will find out how God is the only one able to cast his judgment upon man, and how the one he chose will redeem us through it all. What does it mean for judgment to belong to God alone? To judge someone is to cast a decision which may create a situation for you or a loved one. To judge is to remark on someone's behavior. But are we truly worthy to judge someone else for their sins? Isn't it arrogant of us to judge others for the way they look, for the way they dress, for how they speak to us? These are just a few examples on how we view each other as fellow human beings. In modern culture, when someone is being judged, they are either judged in front of a courtroom with a jury weighing in, or a family member disapproving you for not meeting their expectations. Casting judgment happens in our everyday lives, even if we don't like to admit it. If we see something that we don't like, instantly start to criticize it harshly. An example of this would be the food we eat. We could see someone eating junk food and instantly say that, oh, they're going to get out of shape by eating all of that. But we then turn around and eat the same things 3 days later. An example of judgment can also be found in the Bible, such as in the scriptures of Matthew chapter 12, verse 36 and 37. and 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 10. A great story which depicts judgment is the story of when Jesus healed a man on the Sabbath. In this story, Jesus was just strolling into Jerusalem and he spotted an ill man amongst the blind, lame, and paralyzed. Jesus walked up to the man and asked him, "Why are you here?" The man told him he has been ill for 38 years. So Jesus then told the man to stand up, grab your mat, and walk. And as he was commanded, the man stood. He grabbed his mat and he walked off. The man was so joyous that other people started noticing him. And while the other Jews told him to rest his mat, for this is the Sabbath, the holiest day, the rest day, he told them that someone has healed him, and that someone was Jesus. So now, the other Jews realize that this man has been healed on the holiest of days, and they started to instantly persecute Jesus for healing a man on the Sabbath. But Jesus responded to them, saying, "My Father is still working, and I also am working." This was one of many actions that led to Jesus being crucified for our sins, which I consider the worst judgment of all mankind. We are told to judge, but not hypocritically. For why see the speck of dirt upon another's coat when yours is dirty? We must remember that we are not perfect. We are not to be judging others for simple things they have done. The judgment we cast shall be returned to us by the one who was chosen. For if we persecute another, we shall be persecuted the same. But what does it mean to have judgment casted upon us? We must remember to be vigilant of what we say and do. For those things will be carried up to the judgment seat in front of all the other Christians to see. And it would all be portrayed. All of our mistakes we have made. All of our wrongdoings. All of our sins we have ever thought of committing. The good and the bad. Everything will be on show for all to see. When our sins are weighed by God, he will either show us his face with grace or turn it away. God casts judgment divinely and fairly to all, no matter how tall, huge, or small you are. We are one in the same in the eyes of God, yet all individually blessed by him. So in conclusions, humans are able to judge others. But we must remember that we are not perfect people without putting God in our lives first. God sent us Jesus to help us and teach us to show love to one another. Yet we ended up judging the one who was chosen to help walk us out of sin and condemned him to the cross where he died for ours. But we are not alone in our lives. For God sent us the Holy Spirit to guide us and protect us along our life's journey, to get closer to him by learning and interpreting the many lessons his Son has provided for us. We must learn to not judge another too quickly, for we are just as impure as the vile sinner who has not repented and turned his life to God. So go in peace and remember that God was with us before we were even a thought. For he molded us and shaped us from the womb. And we must remember his teachings and carry them to our tomb. Now finish with asking us a question. Are we truly ready for our sins to be judged at the judgment seat? Or must we prepare for the inevitable and change ourselves to be better? Amen.
I have a maker.
maker. He formed my heart before even time began. My life was in his hands. He knows my name. He knows my every thought. He sees each tear that falls and hears me when I call. I have a Father. He calls me his own. He'll never leave me, no matter where I go. And he knows my name. Yes, he does. He knows my every thought. He sees each tear that falls and hears me when I call. He knows your name. He knows your every thought. And he sees your tears that fall and hears you when you call. He hears you when you call. Yes, he does. He hears us when we call.
Now for a closing prayer. Dear Lord, thank you for teaching us how to judge each other, for creating us from before time. Thank you for giving us worth in your eyes. Help us to live as the one you uniquely intended us to be. Help us abide instead of striving, living peacefully and joyfully as heirs to your kingdom and co-heirs with Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. And now for the benediction. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and forevermore. Amen.
May the Lord bless us and keep us. May the Lord smile on us, shine his light upon us. May the Lord lift us, turn his face towards us, give us his peace, give us his peace. Go now in peace. Go now in peace.
Good morning, my brothers and sisters of the Leeward Islands District, the members and officers of the St. Maarten Circuit. Express our sincere appreciation to you for fellowshipping with us as we explored the theme, Worth It to Christ. We give a special thank you Indeed, to all those who enabled these productions to be what they were. But more importantly, if not especially, we thank the participants, the Reverend Doris Lynch Gibbs, and our youth and young adults, all of whom will be participating in Encuentro 2024. May God's blessings be with them as they continue to discover their worth in Christ, but more importantly, their worth to Christ as witnesses to His glory and honor. We thank our media team for what they have done in producing these presentations each morning, and we pray God's blessing upon them. Lastly, but by no means, I wish to express thanks to Sister Janice James for coordinating and leading this effort. So, my brother, my sister, may God bless you, may God strengthen you, and it is my hope that these devotions have helped you to discover your worth to Christ. Amen. Do have a wonderful day. Amen.